Brother Webb is not doing well tonight. Sister Webb called, want us to really pray for him. He's weak in his body, and I think he's going to the doctor tomorrow to see what's going on. There's others that's sick. Several that's sick kept calling. Sick Brother Turner's sick tonight. But let's believe God's a healer. How many know he is a healer? God can reach and touch these bodies, whatever they need in them. The head colds and the fevers and all those things that's going around. 79 degrees yesterday in February. Back again, almost 60-something today, and then back to 40 almost now. So weather moving back and forth, it causes a lot of drainages and sinuses and colds. But how many is glad God let you be here tonight? And, you know, and we're here. The psalmist says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. So I'm glad to be in the house of God tonight. You say, well, Brother Hunt, I ain't feeling too good. I'm real tired, but you're still here. Amen. You still got breath. Everybody got breath tonight. Say, all right, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Let's clap our hands one more time to him. Say, I love you, Jesus. God, I praise you. Let your Holy Ghost touch this house. In Jesus' name. Let's don't forget about this weekend services. We believe we're going to have a great time Sunday. God's going to fill this house. And also, we're going to take up prayer requests. Anybody's got a need tonight? Anybody? Sister Edith? Amen. God understands and knows. Sister Erica? Amen. In Jesus' name, God, touch you. Over here, Sister Hunt. All right. Remember those needs, Sister Courtney. All right. Somebody else? Anybody tonight need touching your lives, your body? Brother No. All right. Yeah, Sister Lisa needs prayer. Brother Johnson. Sister Johnson, pray for them. Anybody else? Sister Betsy. All right. God knows, Sister Betsy. Sister Tyler Child. All right. You know what I like about these prayer requests? Most of these requests you guys had tonight, the people are not here. Matter of fact, Sister Child's request is in Texas. But you know what? We speak the word. God can move that far away just like that. That's the kind of God we've got tonight. How many believe God can touch every need in this room? Amen. Can we agree together with your neighbor and let's pray. Lord, I love you. I thank you for this opportunity just to reach out and worship you tonight. God, you didn't have to give us this opportunity, but God, we won't ever want to take it for granted. We want to come tonight, lift up our hands and worship you. But I pray for the sick that are in this room, God, I pray you'll reach out and touch their lives, touch their body. You see the families that need prayer, Sister Edith's family, I pray you'll move in the situation or lives. God, we want you to move, Lord, and let man move out the way, and God, you move into that situation. God, touch the Johnson family, Sister Hunt, God, touch her body, Lord, her brother-in-law, touch Richard tonight, we bind with him, Sister Betsy, God, touch her unspoken request. Lord, you are a healer in every need that's in this room, and I believe you're going to touch Sister Courtney's need, Lord. Give her the touch to her life. We just bind together and believe tonight, God, you're going to move for Sister Child's dad in Texas, God. From here, you can move. Touch his life where he's at, Lord. Touch Sister Lisa Underwood today. Heal, God, that mouth problem she's having, Lord, in her teeth. And God, you see the needs that are spoken in this room tonight. We bind for it tonight. Could we everybody just say, Lord, we believe it in the name of Jesus. You can touch these knees. Come on, say in the name of Jesus. Oh, come on, say it like you mean. In the name of Jesus, I believe you're going to heal Sister Turner and Brother Turner's bodies as well. In Jesus' name, Sister Webb, touch her body. Sister Zombie, all of these that are sick. God is a healer. And if you believe that, God is going to touch you. Would you worship as they sing tonight?
We worship you tonight because of who you are, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. He's worthy. He's worthy. Hallelujah. We lift you up, Jesus, in this place tonight. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Taking every part of me.
let's just lift our hands. Oh, come on, let him just take over every part of you tonight. Lord, I love you. I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Isn't it amazing what God can do when we just let him? It's amazing what he'll do when we will step out of the way and just let God work in his way. But so often we want to take control of it. We want to put our hands on it. We want to make sure it steers the way it satisfies our soul. But when you let God, that's when our soul just is in awe of what God does in our lives. Amen. You know what I want us to do before I feel to do this tonight, right now. I felt it when they were singing. While you're standing, and I feel that presence I felt in here Sunday, praise God. It's just lingering across this place, and it's still in the house of God tonight. But what I want the church to do right now, I want us to pray for our church. I want you to pray. You say, what's wrong with the church? There's nothing wrong with the church. It's just we want to pray that God moves it forward in the way he sees fit. We need to get a new building built. There's a little loops we're trying to jump through. But how many believe God's got it all in his hands? I want you to believe with me tonight. The bank is putting the finished touches on things. And I want God's favor to be in all of it. How about you guys? Not my favor, not your favor, but God's favor. Could you lift your hands and let's pray for the will, God's will to be done through the banking and through the architects, whatever needs to be done. God, in your name, I pray, God, and I bind with our church tonight. You're going to reach out and touch, Lord, the building project, Lord, that you have in your will. Lord, I know it's your will, God. You've already spoke to my heart, and I know it says go forward, that now's the time. But God, I want your will to be done, God, on the right timing, when you're ready. But God, move upon the minds and the hearts of those who's prepared this way before us today. I pray that you'll touch, God. Everything comes back, God, in your will and your way. God, if we want to get out of the way and put it directly towards you, God. Your hand is on it, and I believe tonight, God, as we pray and bind together as a church, God, there's not enough devils in hell to stop what you have planned. Amen. For the whole project, in the name of Jesus, I believe it to be done. And the church said, amen. God bless you tonight. You can be seated. Amen. We're going to take up our Wednesday night offering. If the ushers would come tonight, amen, and receive the Wednesday night offering. Praise the Lord. And my wife's going to get ready to come and sing tonight. I'm looking forward to hearing her sing as well. Praise the Lord. But while they're getting ready, somebody that wants to testify tonight, we don't do a testimony a lot, but there's somebody that's got a burning testimony. Would you testify tonight? Anybody? Praise the Lord. That's really excited what God's doing in your life. Anybody excited? There's one. All right. Praise the Lord. Amen. Somebody else want to testify tonight? Hallelujah. Praise God. Brother Ralph, go ahead. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord, Brother Ralph. Amen. Anybody else got a testimony? Praise the Lord. All right, Brother Art East. Well, praise God. Amen. Isn't that awesome? I wonder how that would go over today if we did that today. Praise the Lord. It better be the Holy Ghost, huh? Praise God. Brother Norris, testify, my friend. Praise God. Amen. Yes, sir. That's right. Amen. That's good. Let's give him a hand for that. That's awesome. Praise the Lord. Praise. Somebody else want to testify? Going quick. All right. Well, we're going to take up a good offering, because if you didn't testify, you got to give $20 tonight. Praise the Lord. So give you a chance to. I gave y'all a chance. Praise the Lord. Anybody else want to testify again? All right. We're going to take up an offering tonight, give you a chance to give. Lord, we love you. We thank you for this opportunity to give in this offering tonight. We ask you to bless it, God. Bless the givers tonight. I pray you'll touch every heart that's in this room as they give unto you, Lord. And I ask you to return it back to them fourfold. In the wonderful name of Jesus, we praise you. Amen. Sister Hunt.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm so thankful for his beautiful presence. And Saturday night at a prayer meeting, my prayer above anything, what kept coming back to me is, Lord, let this remain to be a temple of praise to you. Because no matter what we do, if this is not a temple of praise to him, it's in vain. And I was thinking, you know, myself, I second-guessed myself a lot. Did I say the right thing? Did I do the right thing? Did I talk too much? Was I too honest about it? Or, you know, but one thing I know, that my God, we don't have to second-guess him. He does the right thing, and his word is true. And in my quiet time that I'm learning, and then I forget about it, and then something happens, and I learn to get my quiet time again. But, you know, the Lord has spoke to me, and he said that when you are not delivered from something and you have to go through something, when none of the little magic potion spells that you can say, I would tell Sister Edith, if you would pray in Jesus' name, give him the reason why you want your healing, clap three times, spin in the circle four times, and God's going to heal you. You know, I thought I had it, but I didn't, because God, he does everything right. I would mess it up. I would become a spoiled brat. But when we do go through something, if we become what he wants us to be, nothing is lost. Nothing is wasted. And my faith is in him. I have confidence in him, and just worship God with us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. From side to side, like a ship from a raging tide, I don't worry and I don't fret. My God has never failed me yet. Troubles come from time to time, but that's all right. I'm not the worrying kind, because I've got confidence. God is gonna see me through, no matter what the case may be. Sick for oh so long, till the flesh fell from his bones. His wife, cattle, and children, everything that he had was gone. But Job, in his despair, he knew that God still cared. Sleepless days and sleepless nights, Job said, honey, that's all right.
But he will do it for me. Praise the Lord. He has done it too many times, Brother Mike England. I have been in the lion's den, so to speak. And I've been in the fiery furnaces, so to speak. And I've been to the point of death several times in my life. But you know what? God brings me through it. You know why? Because I kept worshiping him. If you ever lose your praise, you're in trouble. If you ever lose your faithfulness, you're in trouble. Some people say, well, I don't believe you have to be an emotion or you don't have to be faithful to everything. Yes, you do. Because if you ever lose either one of them, the devil's going to have your lunch. He's going to eat his lunch and your lunch. Every time you get depressed, he's going to come against you. But you see, when you got an extra strength in your bag and you can reach back there, even David grabbed 5 smooth stones. A lot of them think it's to kill his brothers. I think it's in case he missed the first time. He's got 4 more tries. That's what I really believe. Friend, you got to have some extra in your bag because it's a Monday coming. It's a Tuesday coming. We ain't in church every day. Sometimes you got to reach back in your bag. And that's what the praise on a Wednesday night does. We get over the hump night, the middle of the week night. Because I'm telling you, you miss about 2 or 3 services in a row. You get more depressed, you get down, you get out. But when you give God some praise every time you can, it's almost like putting fuel in your car. Amen. It makes you want to keep on going. And I'm going to tell you, you say, I don't know about all that, Brother Hunt, but that's why I'm still here, because I made up in my mind. If it hair lifts the devil, as they say, I'm going to worship God. And I'm going to magnify him. I'm going to be faithful to him. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. You can be seated. How many is ready for some preaching tonight? I've got a special speaker tonight that nobody has heard yet, and I'm excited to have this family in our church. Aren't we glad to have all the Johnson family that's here tonight? And so the gentleman that's going to preach for us tonight, if it wasn't for him, none of them would be back there tonight. All these Johnsons that are with them, and it all started right here with the way those that are here tonight. And Brother Elder Johnson is going to come tonight. Brother Freddie Johnson is going to preach for us and obey the Holy Ghost, and I'm excited to have him and his family. So let's preach with him tonight. Let's let the Holy Ghost move. Everybody say, Lord, bless him good tonight. Anoint him. Go ahead, say, anoint him, Lord, in Jesus' name. Preach, brother. Amen.
Hallelujah. Good to be here tonight. Give me a moment. Get my notes together. Praise God. I like what I feel in this church. I believe the power of God is in here. I believe it's up to us. Amen. The service is what you make it. I don't know if they got my email I sent. Got it. Oh, I'm doing good. Praise God. Hallelujah. Ain't God good to us? Amen. I love a church that worships God. So don't get cold on me. When you feel like raising your hand, that's all right. When you feel like shouting, that's all right, because praise is always in order. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I got a feeling that this is a church that will make you preach. Amen. Praise God. If it be all right, if it be permissible, I'd like for my wife to testify right now. Amen. She got in this on fire of the Lord before I I really wasn't into it. God worked on me a long time. He's still working on me, by the way. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. So good to see Brother Hart and Sister Norma. Amen. And Sister Haley, I don't know if she's here tonight. Amen. We did get in church at about the same time. It was an awesome revival. And you know, I believe God wants revival for this church. Amen. Praise God. If you'll stand for just a moment for the reading of the Word, I'm going to be reading out of St. Luke chapter 5, starting at verse 1. Amen. And it came to pass, as the people pressed upon him to hear the Word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Amen. Praise God. Brother Hunt, would you pray over the word tonight? Praise God, you may be seated. Amen. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep, and let down your nets for a draught. Hallelujah. Amen. And Simon responded, and he said, Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night, and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Hallelujah. Amen. What we need to do tonight is say, God, I've been doing things my way. Amen. And God, I've tried to do it, and I've tried to catch those fish. Amen. And I've used my net all night long. Amen. And I'm tired, and I don't feel like thrusting out the net anymore. But God, nevertheless, at your word, I'm going to let down the net. What I want to speak to you about tonight would be tested faith. Amen. It takes faith even to come to know God. It says without faith, it's impossible to please him, that he that cometh to God must believe that he is. And he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. That means that we need to be careful about seeking God. We need to have a made up mind that we're going to seek after him. Peter was tired. Hadn't caught anything all night. But he said, nevertheless. Amen. Nevertheless. I know it might not look good. But nevertheless, Lord, you told me to let down the net. Hallelujah. And he said, at thy word. Woo! Hallelujah. When you get the word of the Lord, you need to be obedient unto it. Amen. Obedience along with faith is going to make things begin to happen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. I hope I can hold out tonight. Amen. He said, we've toiled all the night and taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net break. And their net break. Hallelujah. When you are obedient to the word of God, as Peter was, the blessing is going to come. Hallelujah. Now, if Peter had said, no, I'm going home, I've been here all night, Lord, and I'm ready to quit, and I'm tired, and had not obeyed the Lord, he never would have received that blessing. Hallelujah. But because he said, I'll go and try one more time, nevertheless, at thy word, I'm going to let down the net. Somebody needs to give him praise tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. I know this is a Wednesday night. Amen. And so often we get caught up in our Wednesday night worship and our Sunday morning worship, and we'll think, well, it's just another Wednesday night, or it's just another day. Let me tell you something. When you want to receive something from God, you need to launch out into the deep and allow God to do something in your life. Hallelujah. God is testing the faith of those that are in this church tonight. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, the net break. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. Woo! Hallelujah. When God pours out a blessing, give, and it shall be given unto you, pressed down, shaken together, overflowing. It won't be enough that you can contain it, because when you obey him in faith, he's going to bless you abundantly. Hallelujah. The Bible says they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships so that they began to sink. Some of us feel comfortable in the shallow water. Amen. It's okay as long as we got our feet planted on the ground. But when you get out a little bit deeper, it gets a little shaky. When you get out even deeper, you have to know how to swim. And I believe God's saying to the church tonight, it's time that we begin to launch out into the deep and receive the blessings of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me. Oh, hallelujah. For I'm a sinful man, O Lord. When the glory of God begins to fall, it's going to get a hold of our heart. Amen. When we come before his mighty presence and the light of God begins to come into our life, it illuminates some things in us that we might not normally see. And Peter said, I am a sinful man. And he got down on his knees and said, depart from me, O Lord. Amen. His faith was tested. Our faith in God is going to be tested. There are going to be times in our life when we're going to have to step out in faith. I'm doing that right now. I'm doing that right now. I had a battle all day long with this, brother. I had to wrestle with it because, you see, I'm not that kind of a person that likes to get up in front of people and speak. But hallelujah, when God begins to get a hold of you, He can do things in your life, hallelujah, that no one else can. Hallelujah. We need to say, God, help me, Lord, to stand before you and allow that testing time in my life to come so that you can make me what you want me to be in you. Hallelujah. It not only affected Peter or Simon. The Bible says here, for he was a sinful man, O Lord, and it says he was astonished. And all that were with him at the draught of the fishes which they had taken. And so was also James and John and the sons of Zebedee, which were partners with Simon. And Jesus said unto Simon, fear not, from henceforth thou shalt catch men. Hallelujah. I've got something else for you, Simon Peter. I've got something else for you, James. I've got something else for you, saints of God. I've got something else for you to do. I know you have your own work ethics, and I know you have your work that you're going to do, but I've got something greater for you to do than that. I'm going to make you fishers of men. And their faith was tested. It's not an easy thing when your faith is tested. Amen. Sometimes people fail, but you got to get back up and say, God, I want you to work on me, Lord. Put me back on the potter's wheel and mold me and shape me into that you would want me to be so that I can be a vessel used of you. Hallelujah. Amen. I didn't know whether to teach or preach or treat or what. But praise God, my wife told me tonight, you need to preach because you're not that good a teacher. Amen. But you know what? I can't do anything without him. I can't, when I can't stand behind this pulpit, God, I say, God, I pray for that anointing. I pray for that anointing that would break the yoke. Amen. I pray for that anointing that would set the captive free. I pray for that anointing that would give deliverance. Hallelujah. Praise God. It wouldn't do good tonight if I didn't bring the one in the story whose faith was tested. Amen. So much, and that is Abraham. Amen. They had a song they used to sing. Father Abraham had many sons. I'm one of them, and so are you. Amen. You are one of his sons tonight if you've been born again. Hallelujah. Through faith in the Word of God. Hallelujah. Through the blood of Christ. Praise God, you're one of the sons of Abraham. Amen. And if you would turn with me to Genesis chapter 22, and I want to touch on that. Can I read it? Let me go in my Bible. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 22, starting at verse 1. Oh, hallelujah. Okay. Amen. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham, and that word tempt there means to try or prove or test. Amen. That God did test Abraham and said unto him, Abraham, and he said, behold, here I am. Amen. And he said, take now thy son, thine only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. Amen. Sometimes the testing of faith requires you to make a great sacrifice. Amen. Now we all know the story. What happened to Isaac? But can you imagine if you had a son and you loved that son more than anything else, and God said, go and sacrifice him on the mountain. Amen. And by the way, this was not Ishmael. This was the son of promise. This was Isaac. And this was the son of promise that he had promised was going to have a nation through him. And now God's telling him, I want you to go, and I want you to take and offer him up as a sacrifice. Amen. His faith was being tested. But do you think he stopped? Do you think he stopped? No, he didn't stop. Go with me, if you would, to verse 6. Amen. And I'm going to be reading here quite a bit. Amen. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son, and he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father and said, my father. And he said, here am I, my son. And he said, behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Now I know this had to be very disturbing to Abraham, because now Isaac is beginning to question what's going on. And he said, I see the wood and I see everything else, father, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Hallelujah. Praise God. And Abraham said, my son, God will provide. Whew. Jehovah Jireh. He is my provider. Something inside of Abraham knew that he was going to obey God and he was going to receive a blessing. Hallelujah. He said, Abraham, Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went both of them together, and they came to the place which God had told them of, and Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay him. I believe that Abraham would have taken his son's life if God had not stepped in, amen, and said, wait a minute. Hallelujah. Amen. Look what he says here. Hallelujah. Praise God. Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son, and the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, here am I. And he said, lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him, for I know now that thou fearest God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. This was faith. Amen. This was tested faith that Abraham had. For I know now that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. Hallelujah. a type and shadow of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who became the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. It was in the mind of God from the very beginning that He was going to send His Son, Jesus Christ, to become the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. And this is a type and shadow of that. And there was a lamb there that was provided. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the stead of his son. Hallelujah. In the stead of his son. Someone else was offered up for you and I in our stead. Someone else bled and suffered and died in agony and went to the cross of Calvary and gave his life in our stead so that we could come to know God as our Lord and our Savior and our soon coming King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He went there for you and I. Hallelujah. The Bible says he could have called 10,000 angels. All he had to do was speak the word. Amen. And those angels would have been sent down. But there was something that held him to the cross. And that was a love for mankind. That was a love for you and I. That held him to that cross because he knew it was the only way that we could be saved. And through the blood of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, we can know him today. We can have salvation. We can have deliverance. Hallelujah, because he went instead of us. And Abraham called the name of the place Jehovah Jireh. Hallelujah. I was thinking about when they were singing that song earlier, Jehovah Jireh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. As it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord it shall be seen, and the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, by myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing and hast not withheld thy son, thy only son, that in blessing, whew, obedience to God, making the sacrifice, the blessing comes. Hallelujah. That in blessing I will bless thee, Abraham, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven. Woo! Somebody needs to shout, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven. Hallelujah, Abraham. Why? Because you were willing to make a sacrifice. You were willing to take that thing that you loved the most and offer it up unto me. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. And as the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Hallelujah. Amen. Today, Abraham is the father of three religions. Amen. I know of no one else. Two of them are false religions. Amen. One more so than the other. But one of them is Christianity. Hallelujah. Because he was willing, Christianity had come about. Because he was willing to give, amen, and give that offering up to God. Hallelujah. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Amen. I've got a few more scriptures, and I hope I'm not holding you too long, but I want to go to Hebrews 11, and this is talking about Abraham, and I thought this was so good. In Hebrews 11, where it talks about the patriarchs of the faith, amen, and starting at verse 17, Okay. By faith, Abraham, when he was tried, offered up Isaac. Amen. He that had received the promise offered up his only begotten son, of whom it was said that in Isaac shall thy seed be blessed. Amen. The seed was going to be blessed through Isaac. And he was willing, amen, to offer up Isaac. Amen. When he knew what the promise had already been given. Praise God. Hallelujah. I can't see that because it's oh, okay. Amen. Of whom it was said that in Isaac shall thy seed be called. And this is the verse that I like. Accounting that God was able to raise him up. Hallelujah. Accounting that God was able to raise him up even from the dead. From whence also he received him in a figure. Hallelujah. He said, I know that if I had to take his life, God was able to raise him up again. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad that we serve a Savior, hallelujah, that was raised up again, Jesus Christ. The Bible tells me death could not hold him. Hallelujah. And on the third day, he arose out of that tomb, overcoming death, hell, and the grave. He has already won the victory for us. Hallelujah. He has already won the battle for us. Hallelujah. He won it when he went to the cross of Calvary and gave his life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I've got a little bit more reading. Is this all right? Amen. I don't want to hold you too long. Amen. But I would like to go to St. Luke chapter 22. And once again, I'm going to bring Peter back into this, where Peter is being tested again. And this is going to be a test where he doesn't come out too good. Amen. Starting at verse 28. Ye are they which have continued with me in my temptations. And he's talking to his disciples during this time. Verse 29, please. And I appoint unto you a kingdom, as my Father hath appointed unto me, that ye may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And he's going there and he's telling them what they're going to get to do. And they're going to eat and drink with him at the table. Amen. And all of this. And all of a sudden he changes the subject. Amen. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan hath desired to have you that he may sift you as wheat. Amen. Testing time again. Hallelujah. Your faith is going to be tested, Peter. Hallelujah. Satan hath desired to sift you as wheat. I wouldn't want that to be said of me. As some of you might think, I can handle it. Yeah. Man, I'm super spiritual. And you, I'm on fire. I got the Holy Ghost. But let me tell you something. When it comes to that, when Satan had desired to tempt you as wheat, praise God, you're in for a bad time. Amen. And he could only do this because Jesus, God, allowed it. God allowed this sifting in Peter's life so that he could be tested, so that his faith, amen, could come through. Let's read this next verse. I love this. But I have prayed for thee. Aren't you glad that somebody Somebody named Jesus is praying for you because he cares about you. He said, I prayed for you that your faith fail not. Hallelujah. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. Jesus was able to see the other side of this picture, but Peter didn't. Peter was thinking, what in the world going on? Next verse, please. And he said unto him, Lord, I'm ready to go with thee, both into prison and to death. Oh, is that so, Peter? Is that so? Huh? Peter makes that statement. God, I'm ready to go with you, Jesus. Amen. Even unto death. He was a little bit cocky. Amen. He really was. He was a little bit full of himself. And it was time for him to be knocked back down a little bit. Amen. Because you see, he was going to use him, but not at this time. His faith had to be tested once again. Amen. And he said, I tell thee, Peter, the cock shall not crow this day before thou shalt thrice deny that thou knowest me. And we all know the story. Peter stood afar off. When Jesus was going through the judgment and all of that, Peter wasn't there. Well, didn't he just say, I'll go with you? And, you know, eventually he stood around a fire, and the Bible says he stood around a strange fire. Amen. He didn't have any business being around that fire. He was with the wrong people. And somebody recognized who he was and said, you're one of them. And he began to say, no, I'm not. He denied him once, twice, three times. Amen. And once again, on that third time when he denied him, the cock crowed. And Peter looked and he saw Jesus. Amen. And he knew he had failed him. And the Bible says he went out and repented. And he cried. And he was so sorry. Amen. But Jesus said, Peter, I'm going to pray for you. Hallelujah. That your faith fail not. It's being tested right now, Peter, but it's not going to fail because you're going to come back stronger than what you were. And you know, I've often wondered, why was it Peter? And you probably have too. Why was he the one that was picked out of the 12 disciples that Satan desired to sift his wheat? Because you see, he had been given the keys. Upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Hallelujah. And when the day of Pentecost came, Peter was right there with them. And the Bible says he stood up and he began to say, this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. Hallelujah. Somebody needs a blessing tonight. Somebody needs to reach out to him tonight and say, God, I want all that you have for me. God, I need another touch of your hand, Lord. Hallelujah. I believe that we need the baptism of the Holy Ghost to envelop our sanctuary to the point that we begin to shout hallelujah and run the aisles and dance in the spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know I used to say at the church we were in, they need to have a sign up front that says dancing is allowed. Amen. You can run if you want to. Hallelujah. Praise God. God didn't give us the Holy Ghost just to keep it. Amen. Amen. And the Bible says, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy. He has saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost. How many need another renewing tonight? Oh, hallelujah. Maybe there's somebody here tonight that hasn't received it. I want you to know God has it for you. God has every need that you would have, and He's wanting you to come unto Him tonight. Shall we all stand? Hallelujah. I had some more scripture, and I'm going to go ahead and just read 1 Peter, starting at chapter 4, verse 12 and verse 13. Start at verse 12. Thank you. Amen. Beloved, and this is Peter, and he's seeing it from the other side now, brother. Think it not strange concerning the fiery trial that is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice, inasmuch as ye are, hallelujah, partakers of Christ's suffering, that when His glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. Somebody shout hallelujah tonight. Praise God. Praise God. He's a good God tonight. We need the fire of the Holy Ghost to come down in this sanctuary tonight. We need a rebaptism of His Spirit. I want to ask you a question tonight. How long has it been since you spoke in tongues? How long has it been since you got down on your knees and began to pray and a spirit of travail came on you? Hallelujah. When a spirit of travail comes on the church, amen, souls are going to be born into the kingdom. Thank you, brother.
Oh, come on, let's give the Lord and Brother Johnson a hand clap tonight. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. I know we all have been tested in our lives, but I think it's in 2017 of February today, we need to put our faith to the test. We need to quit trying to wonder what's going to happen. Let's just go ahead forward with God in our lives. And let's see what, if we believe the Bible, God said, I'll take care of you. I won't leave you. I'm going to go with you all the way. I want us to come to the front tonight, and I want us to pray our way out tonight. God, I'm just going to go on in my life, and I'm going to believe that you're going to take care. You're going to sustain me, Lord. You're going to supply my needs. You are my El Shaddai, God. You are my provider. I thank you for it, Lord. Come on, let's just pray as the singers are singing tonight. Let's give God some glory at this altar. God, I know you're my King. You are my Savior.